Welcome to The Curious Developer. I'm Jesper Petersen from KDAB, and sometimes I lay awake at night pondering about things. And currently I'm pondering about how is AI-driven or AI-assisted development happening inside of our IDEs these days. To help me with that, I brought Jan Margaard on the show, who claims that he is not an AI. But how do I even know that I live in the real universe and not just one driven by AIs? Welcome, Jan.
Hello. Nice to see you again.
You promised me last time that you would show me how to set up Qt Creator, and you did not show me that in the previous episode, so I was up all night trying to get it working, but it asked me about a million different things that I did not understand, and it took me forever to figure out how to even get started. So maybe you can spend a bit of time with me and the audience here to see how it all works. But you actually had one thing you wanted to say to the audience before we got started.
Yeah, right. I did want to mention that we're showing the Qt AI Assistant Qt Creator plugin. And this is currently commercially available as part of your commercial Qt distribution. There's been rumors that this might change, but at the moment, this is how things go. Sorry, Jesper, that you spent so much time setting this up. I hope you at least avoided a few nightmares. And I hope this was the one night in the year that you would have had nightmares in the first place. So as we've been saying, this is an extension to Qt Creator. So we need to install the extension, then we need to change the settings so that the extension works and can connect to ChatGPT or what other model you would want to use. And then we can use it. So first, in order to set up the extension, you have seen extensions in Qt Creator. So here on the left-hand side, you have this extension panel, and here you can search for different extensions. And in the settings here, there is an option to switch on an external repository, and you would need to set up this specific repository here. This is by Qt Company. Again, currently this specific extension will only work if you have a commercial license of Qt.
You gotta love that API, sorry for that. That you can specify one server URL. That's not really thinking about lots of different setup. You can point to the Qt company's extension and that's it. How about if there was somebody else providing extensions? But hey, that's besides the point.
Well, you can manually install an extension from file. So this button makes it also.
Okay.
When you have set up this repository, you will find the Qt company's AI assistant tool here, and then there is also the description of this plugin, and you can activate and deactivate it using this button. Qt Creator needs to restart after you activated the plugin. I have set it up already, so I won't be doing that, but now you've seen how you can get there. Okay, and then the next step is that you need to set up the configuration of your extension so that it can connect to the different model providers. Because the extension only acts as a entry point to communicate with different LLMs, and you probably know there are like many different LLM providers out there. OpenAI is maybe currently the best known one, but there's also Anthropic. Google is also providing LLMs, and you can of course also self-host LLMs using Olama, for example. Then let me show you the settings for the extension. So this is the general settings tab, and you see here, I showed this also last episode. So for most of the modes, we have chosen a GPT setup, and maybe here you have a list of different models that you could use. So there is also Claude Sonnet. Then there is a Llama 3.3 70B QML model. To my knowledge at the moment, this model here is not publicly available, because this is a model that Qt Company has created or fine-tuned. So there's also other models available here. You could use a 13B code llama model for code completion for other languages. There is a DeepSeek code, star coder 2, and others. The same prompting for other languages. There is these three models available here. Okay, but this is so we I have decided to use ChatGPT or GPT 4.0 for most of these setups here, and you will still need a little bit more setup in order to make it work. You need to connect ChatGPT, like the plugin, to the account that you have with OpenAI. And now it gets a little bit difficult, because your normal ChatGPT account will work, but you need to do additional setup. So even if you have a ChatGPT Pro account, you cannot use this plugin using your Pro license. But you need to make some setup that via the OpenAI platform developer API toolkit. So they have the separate developer platform, and you need to use that in order to, like in combination with the plugin. And I have already prepared. So this is the, you see here, this is at platform.openai.com. You can use this with your normal OpenAI account. You will just need to log in into a different web setup. And then you have a, you need to have an organization here. And this organization, every account has like a default organization. We at KDAB, we have our dedicated organization here. So this will look slightly different than it will look for you. Users, because Jesper, you and I will be using the same organization, because last time I checked, we were employed at the same company.
Klarälvdalens Datakonsult AB.
Klarälvdalens Datakonsult AB.
Yeah, that one.
All right, I will not reproduce that. As you can see here, I have set up an API token, and I will show you in a moment where this goes in QCreator. There is a few things to keep in mind here. One is that you need to have set up a billing method, which is a credit card, in the organization account. And the other is that you need to create this API key. And you see I created one Jan's QCreator test, and I have set this key up with what I believe is the minimal permissions that it needs. And you do have an overview here of what I have set up. So I have the models API set to read, which I think might actually not be required, but let's leave it at that. And then the important API here is the model capabilities and especially chat completions. And this I have set to write, which is the only way to access it. Okay, when you create a token like this, it will give you a secret key. You see here the shortened version. And this key you will need to copy and paste into QCreator. And the location to do that is here in the Advanced tab, and then you scroll down to OpenAI GPT and you paste in your authentication token. Now, you guys, probably you will see this token in not obfuscated, but just clear on screen, and we will have revoked this token by the time the video goes up. I already see people commenting about this, right? Good. So one thing is you paste the API token, and the other thing is that you paste the server URL, which is this is the same for all the for all tokens that you can get, because the token encodes your organization and everything. Okay, and after you have set this up, you can start using the plugin nearly exactly the way that I showed last episode. There is one tiny caveat. You see that in the general tab, I have set up code completion for QML using this specialized code llama model. I could use it with ChatGPT too, but here I chose that I want to use the specialized code llama model. And you also see here that we have multiple code llama models to choose from. The 13B model is the one that is publicly available, and the 13B QML one is fine-tuned by Q Company. This is also currently publicly available. How we set this up, I will show in another episode. I just want to point out that in order to make this work, you do need some server to host this model. I think this is this config here. You see we have some GPU server at KDAB that runs this model for me at the moment. This is it in terms of setup. Yeah.
And just to look a bit fast forward, would it be even possible to host this locally?
I don't need to set this up on a dedicated server. As you can see from the screen recording, I have a MacBook, and MacBooks make it rather easy to run small models directly on the system with GPU support. So yes, this could be running locally on my system as well.
Just don't do it when you're out flying, because you'll heat up the whole airplane with a fan output from the GPUs working very hardly.
Yes, that's
or very
true.
Hard, I guess. Okay. That's that was way more than I had anticipated. I mean, with the plugin for GitHub Copilot, that was basically just giving it my access key and I was done. Why is it so much more complicated here, you think?
I would think that OpenAI currently has kind of two main target users for things. One is the ChatGPT interface for most people. And OpenAI seems to also try that people use that as a dedicated app on their system, and then this app can access different applications, right? So this is the main entry point for users. And then they offer this whole programming API that allows you to integrate OpenAI LLMs into your application. And the normal way to deploy this is that you would have an access key for a specific app. So you as a developer have an access key, but not every dedicated user uses one.
In the next episode, we will go much deeper. I have lots and lots of questions about all these different models. I mean, bigger is better. I've learned that on, what was that TV show from the 2000s? That does not seem to be the case all the time here, but we'll get much more into that. Thank you very much, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.